A question. Character. Roy Adams is back. Roy Adams is still as dangerous and proficient as ever. However, he no longer works for the president. Roy Adams now works for dead presidents. This is Operation Thunderbolt. Roy Adams learned that rescue missions lead to copious amounts of Fetty. He abandoned work for Uncle Sam and instead began working for the almighty dollar. Roy Adams is now a mercenary. He has teamed with another ex-Special Forces soldier turned soldier of special fortune, Hardy Jones. Hardy Jones yields his accomplishments, warrior experience, and tenure, as well as a handy mustache, as well as a Mac-10. Roy Adams retires his trusty Israelian Uzi for this updated submachine gun favored by the criminal drug underworld. Roy Adams will use it for good instead of cocaine, but most certainly for copious amounts of Fetty. This is Operation Thunderbolt. They are contracted by the CIA, both former members of the 5th Special Forces Group Airborne, exceptionally trained warriors, renowned for their ability to operate independently, conduct missions in austere environments, and deploy in small teams. And it does not get any smaller than two people. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones share the inner tube. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones bring a wealth of special force combat experience to the battlefield and throw it out the window. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones walk directly in the middle of the street, shooting anything in sight. Military men, military cats. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones are aware of creatures of munitions. This is Operation Thunderbolt. An airplane carrying people is hijacked by deceptive terrorists dressed in ski masks and varsity jackets. They are not Lettermen. The terrorists fly their jet of terror to the war-torn land of Kalubia, directly next to the Mediterranean Sea. The terrorists demand the release of their brothers of terror. Terrible brothers. Otherwise, they will murder the passenger hostages, as well as their handsome pilot. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones will not let these sexy people die. This is Operation Thunderbolt. They will meet with a native woman of purple for intelligence. Interesting intelligence. She guides them through their mission, pointing at the enemy and telling the duo, "There they are. Impressive." Roy Adams and Hardy Jones are masters of the obvious camouflage. Roy Adams forms the shape of white man tree, while Hardy Jones transforms into the soul bush. This is Operation Thunderbolt. During Operation Wolf, Roy Adams developed a resistance towards explosions and bulletry. Roy Adams taught this technique to Hardy Jones. They have now developed a resistance to anything. They withstand multiple rockets, numerous grenades, millions of bullets, while only wearing military garb and resplendent hats. Their bodies suck up the knives. They teach this technique to their vehicles. The Jeep is invincible. The boat is unsinkable. Defeat is unthinkable. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones arm themselves with rockets and Mac-10 ammo. They shoot their ammo to gain their ammo. The only way they will get rid of their Mac-10 is to pry it out of their cold, dead hands. But that will never happen. They've got a plane to catch. This is Operation Thunderbolt. After rescuing the innocent passengers of leisure, the duo use their infallible accuracy to discern between the terrorist and idiot hostages. Timmy and Catherine's minds have been rendered idiot due to psychological stress. Finally, they reach their pulchritudinous captain, their only hope of escape, as he is the only pilot in the land of Kalubia that can transport the duo and the hostages. Roy Adams and Hardy Jones will again apply their skillful efficiency to shoot the terrorist captor, or at least as much as they can. It is necessary for the captain to take bullets, and the terrorist takes a greater amount of the rescue shots. A perfectly sensible outcome. Hooray! Another operation completed by Roy Adams. And the first Christopher Hardy. Regardless, whenever danger calls, they will answer. As long as they get that fatty. This is Operation Thunderbolt. Please join me as I discuss The Principal with James Eldred of Cinema Oblivia, a film about a lovable loser who becomes principal as punishment. He will take back this rambunctious school of rudeness while exclaiming no more on Cinema Oblivia, your home for discussions on disregarded, tossed aside, thrown away, outdated, out of fashion, or otherwise unremembered films. Next episode. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the Wonder Boy will play. Quest with me. Learn with us. Enrich your mind. Empower your inquiry. Like our material. Subscribe to our page. Put character into question. Return every Monday for more. A question. Of character.